disposal of the burial of Bin Laden's remains was done in strict conformance with Islamic precepts and practices. It was prepared in accordance with the Islamic requirements. We early on made provisions for that type of burial, and we wanted to make sure that it was going to be done, again, in strict conformance. So it was taken care of in the appropriate way. I'm not going to go into details about sort of the where, but that burial has taken place. It took place earlier today, our time. It was determined that there is the requirement in Islamic law that an individual be buried within 24 hours. Went inside of Pakistan, carried out the operation, he was killed, he was removed from Pakistan. There were certain steps that had to be taken because of the nature of the operation. We wanted to make sure we were able to do that in the time period allotted for it. Going to another country, making those arrangements, requirements, would have exceeded that time period in our view. And so therefore we thought that the best way to ensure that his body was given an appropriate Islamic burial was to take those actions that would allow us to do that burial at sea. There's dialogue going on with our counterterrorism counterparts in the aftermath of this. They're expressing understanding about the reasons why we did this. They are appreciative that it was done without having Pakistani casualties outside of that compound. The U.S.-Pakistani relationship, which is a strategic relationship, goes on a number of different areas and levels. Counterterrorism is one of them. It can be a complicated matter. As I said, we don't always agree on some of the things that we want to do, but through that continued dialogue and communication, I think we get where we need to be. This is one more incident that we're going to have to deal with, and we look forward to continue to work with our Pakistani colleagues because they are as much, if not more, on the front lines of the battle against terrorism.